Perfect. See, it's panning out, camera panning out. Welcome to Inside the Ant Farm.
Welcome to Westworld. Inside the Ant Farm.
This is our Westworld spoiler cast, guys. This is 197 now. We have only three left before 200.
Yeah.
You have all the plans ready for the big 200s out
there? I actually have some plans in the works.
I have something too, man. I'm in charge of the glasses, we'll say. I'll show you afterwards.
Okay. We might be doing it on location, let's just say.
Well, let me know ahead of time so I can tell my wife.
No, I'll let her know first. It's a surprise for you. 200. But we're not there yet. We're 197, guys. And we got...
something that must be in the name. It must be an alias for a vagina. It must be.
100%. This is Firestone Velvet Merlin.
I put it in her Velvet Merlin, if you know what I'm saying.
And then she showed me her Velvet Merlin.
Oh, yeah. Like a totally Arthurian legend.
Yeah.
Gross. I like that. So that's definitely something Percival would say.
Definitely the sword and the stone, you know what I'm saying?
Galahad, the chaste.
Or maybe... Maybe the balls in the egg hole, as they said on his trailer. The honest trailer for Empire Strikes Back. They were he's like, hey, the last one, they put the balls in the egg hole. And showed they're putting the biscuit in the basket. I was like, oh, man.
Oh, like one, two.
By the way, that was the best honest trailer because he couldn't think of anything bad to say.
It's a great movie. It's a fucking great movie. That's why.
It was actually pretty terrific. How you doing, man?
I'm doing good, man. I'm all, you know, obviously a little under the weather. I sound a little gruff today.
You sounded worse 2 days ago. So
much worse. So it's kind of good we didn't do the podcast yesterday because I would have just been like, I would have just sounded like Joe Cocker, like gasping his last breath before he dies. I was that bad yesterday.
2 days ago, I was great when I saw you.
What's the funniest part, though, is, like, I actually feel fine. I got sick for, like, on Monday, I got, like, nose sick, and I was like, oh, I'm going to get sick, and then it just went, and just stays right here for the next 4 days.
That's actually just been happening to me the last couple years when I get sick.
I've never had it before.
When I throw it, it sucks, because it's scary, because that's where
I sing. Well, we were going to sing it. Actually, yeah. Matt, I got a song for you after this over.
You're gonna sing it tonight?
Listen to it, Matt. We can do it in the band. It's called Rag and Bones Human. Rag and Bones Man is the name of the artist. Human is the name of the song.
Alright.
Pretty good.
Okay.
How you doing, big guy?
Better than I was yesterday. We were supposed to do this yesterday.
Somebody's a bitch.
2 days ago, my son got a stomach bug, which I think he might have got from Gemma. But Gemma...
By the way, if you give me a stomach bug,
I hope I do now. I really want you to know.
Like, balls and dick both up into your body. Like, they'll invert, and you'll be like, oh, I have a vagina now. Oh, I've got a trans surgery.
Or are you going to wait till it's erect at least?
Yes. Okay. No, that's the best way to do it. If you don't want to flaccid, it's going to be all over the place. Really wobbly.
But 2 days ago, I was fine, and then woke up with it yesterday. I thought I could power through it. I didn't throw up. My stomach was just really, I was really dizzy and queasy. And then so, like, right after I put Aiden to bed, I'm like, oh, I'm going to get ready to go. No, it was right before I put Aiden to bed. I was going to go over after I put him to bed and go to your house, but I was like, ugh. I was like, I got up and I just started shaking, and I had, like, put a blanket over me. I'm like, I'm going to call Mike and let him know that I probably shouldn't attempt this.
I was confused. I was like, what is he calling me this
early? And it would have been better to come over yesterday, though, weather-wise, because it's freaking...
It's the winter wonderland. By the way, we had... So, Syracuse Stage, obviously, I work at Syracuse Stage. We have a show tonight, and the weather forecast was like, oh, it's going to stop right after, like, 5 or something. You'll be fine. So we're like, okay, well, the show must go on. Is the show canceled? Is the show canceled? And sold out show. Like, the whole entire run is sold out for Mary Poppins. We're doing Syracuse Stage. And so we're like, you got to come tonight because we're not canceling. And then this happened.
Do you think people are going to ask for the tickets, their money back and stuff tomorrow?
Oh, they definitely will. And I'm going to have to say no. A lot. A lot, a lot.
Sorry. A lot. We told you could show up, bitch.
Well, we have a no refund policy. Oh.
Yeah. So. At all? Refunds. It's like none?
We give off the time. We have a no refund policy. I'm a nice guy. I'm not horrible. I'm not a monster. I'm kind of a monster, though.
Hey, let's get some news. What do we got here?
Yeah, I have a ton of news, because... I hope we have some of the same stuff because I have a ton
first,
of shit.
Before we get started, on a somber note, RIP Alan Thicke.
Man. It couldn't be. Fuck you, 2016.
2016 is just taking
shitty
people.
Shitty.
I think like December 31st, it's gonna kill every single
yeah,
person.
Just
we
like yeah, like no.
Chris Pratt dies. Like
no.
Bruce Campbell's gonna kill.
Yeah. Like, no, don't do it. Not him too. Not him too. But it's yeah, they're gonna.
Dwayne the Rock Johnson's gonna die in a
fire
accident
like
or
Matrix
something.
And like not like this. Just fall over, dead. Damn it. By the way, yeah, Chris Pratt. Have you seen the Chris Pratt and Jennifer Lawrence?
I haven't heard
things.
Really good.
Fucking great.
All of them. Watch it later. Every one of them. There's what. There's funny. I saw the thing where he kept petting Jennifer Lawrence out of all his selfies and pictures.
Wired is doing this one where they have a Google search, top Google search interview, and basically they read like the top Google searches and they answer the question. So it's like how. It was like, is, so sometimes, is Chris Pratt? And then, like, whatever the next word is, like, is Chris Pratt dead?
Yeah.
Is Chris Pratt, like, Canadian? Yeah. Like, you know? Yeah. Yeah. And so like, none of them were, like, rude or anything, but the one was, is Chris Pratt dead? And he's like, inside? But, yeah,
I heard of the insult one. I have to look at
the insult one's really funny, too. There's also, Rogue One cast is another, there's an internet search, Wired magazine interview, and it's very funny, too. But yeah, I recommend both those if you get a chance, guys. Matt will post them in the comments.
Yeah, just like I always do.
Because he's now I don't think ever,
I do all those. I do all those.
You've ever like done any? I know you did. You did. You posted the one. You didn't edit it. I don't think, but you posted the one.
I did post one out of
197. Out of 197. Then our editor, of course, whose name is not to be revealed. We won't reveal it ever. But yeah.
You
but
didn't say
check it out. Chris plus Jennifer Lawrence.
Okay.
Sorry, I don't think. That's the first one. Yeah. RIP, I don't think. I think he was on here.
Rogue One reviews are looking great, by the way. It comes out. It'll come out.
I'm watching it Friday. I watch it when this podcast is going up. I'll be there watching it.
I wish.
Because my friend's having a birthday party, and his birthday wanted to go see Rogue One.
It's
and
pretty
so,
good birthday.
I didn't think I'd be able to go, because I thought I'd be working at the mall, but then they canceled it, so I'm going to be at the mall instead doing that.
Pretty sweet.
Good idea.
Pretty sweet. So they finally canceled, or just for tomorrow?
No, the whole thing's because it wasn't. We weren't doing any business. We're just sitting at a table. I was okay. I actually wanted to try and change it up and do something else, but they thought that we were going to need me there, which was good because they didn't need me at the stage. So.
And most of the Rogue One reviews are saying like 9 out of 10. There's a couple
it's
that
man, it's Rouge One.
There's a couple I saw that were where people were comparing it to Empire Strikes Back and like. Greatness.
Well, of course they were. Of course they were.
That's saying a lot, you know, especially for Star Wars fans. So that's a lot of hype.
I mean, Gareth Edwards said he wanted to take like kind of a darker tone, like Empire Strikes Back. So it makes sense.
Well, it's very. I guess it's a different tone than any of the movies in the grittiness. So, like it's you don't get this kind of glory.
I'm excited for the K2 droid played by Alan Tudyk. Yeah, there's a Japanese like, it's like a character piece trailer for just him, and it was really cool. But it was even funnier because it was like his lines in English should have been like okay cool something in Japanese
they did the
it was just like
they had the
simulation challenge
yeah they had the ninja warrior dudes yeah. Where
Sagado Sagado yeah basically you're like oh okay they're saying something in Japanese that and like hi I'm gonna kill this dude yeah and K2 is pretty badass in that trailer too like he's just. He's definitely not like a C-3PO or like an R2-D2. He's
like
very
the opposite
much
of C-3PO.
Yeah, very much kind of sassy.
So he'd be the top of C-3PO's.
Oh, he's like a power top, dude. Yeah. Like a power top. Like one of the funny things they did is they showed him pick up a stormtrooper, throw him into another stormtrooper, and go, defenses are neutralized or something like that. And I was like, nice, nice. It was all in altitude, so I did a very good job. So I'm excited for that.
All I'm saying is this movie. It's
Rouge One. Rouge One. Now, speaking of fucking great movies coming out, this is one coming out a little in the future, but the Fast and Future 8 is going to have a new name. It's going to be called The Fate of the Furious.
The Fate of the Furious.
And so the trailer looks like, it looks like car porn's final form. Like if car porn like just fusioned, it'd be like that.
The Fate.
So we can see what their fate is? Well, basically the trailer looks like Dom, of course, played by Vin Diesel, is going rogue.
Michael Vincent, yeah.
Like he's joining up with Charlize Theron's character.
But is he?
But he is. He's going against the whole team. His car hits the Rock's car off a bridge.
Oh no, Hobbs.
Yeah. hops. Good old hops.
Send them down to meet old hops.
Yeah, send them down to meet old hop. It could be. It could. They, it's not that intelligent. They didn't think. No, they did not. There's no way to fuck them. So they're
supposed to be like family.
Yeah, so that's right. So all the rest of the family's trying to trying to stop him.
He said it.
And can they?
Do they have the Tokyo Drift guy at least?
No, but Jason Statham is in a scene. There's a scene where like the Rock and Jason Statham were like gonna fight each other, and like there's no way Jason Statham's winning that.
I don't know, Jason Statham, like, he was a member of the transport. He was winning those fights, okay?
He's get the oil on. He's getting the rock bottom. Some oil. Like, oh, you have to do a little.
What happens if the Rock's open? He rings the doorbell, the Rock goes to open the door, and he kicks the door out.
That's me, the only way, but they're in jail, Dad. Like, just bars. Oh. Prison bars.
And yeah, you probably see him coming.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, really.
And being in solitary confinement. Solitary confinement.
Yeah,
it's a door. That'd be the worst. You're
in solitary confinement, and then someone kicks a door.
First of all, there's a doorbell. You're like, there's a doorbell? And then you go to get the door, and you get your face.
You probably think it's just food, because you're in solitary confinement.
Like, oh, I'll get some dog food.
Oh, cool. Oh, no, I got kicked. Fuck. Damn.
They're playing that song from Walking Dead every time
he gets a dark man sandwich. By the way,
I haven't watched it.
Good. It's very good to like.
I'm listening to Lore right now. It's from.
Yeah, I'm
listening to Lore.
I think I'll watch it with Jamie. Good. Jamie's liking Dark Banner, which is good.
Let me make sure.
I got a thing. I said it all in one.
You said it
car,
all.
Car, porn, okay. Spinal Fluid.
So in a recent interview, Adam Driver said that he doesn't think that Episode 8 should have a trailer. Because obviously we're all assuming that Episode 8 is going to have a trailer.
I'm sure it won't, Adam.
It's gonna. I'm sure he'll be wrong.
He
said, he doesn't think it should have a trailer, because he's like, I think it would be actually cause more hype for the movie if you didn't put a trailer, because everybody's gonna be excited about this movie already.
Oh, no,
no matter what you put,
I'm gonna shit myself if there's no trailer.
So obviously, we all want a trailer, but do you think it needs a trailer?
It's going to have a trailer.
Theoretically, this isn't.
But in theory, like I said, I would fucking shit myself if there's just no trailer. I want to do it without a trailer. I'm gonna see it with no matter what.
That's what he said. He's like, you know, I think that people would be more excited if there wasn't.
No,
like,
he's right, but I don't want to be that excited.
Well, I think
I would be less excited.
I think too, there's so much that would leak if you didn't put a trailer out that it would just probably leak the whole movie.
Well, the thing is too is like exactly. I think like the whole thing, any trailer would be a fucking spoiler. Like anything is gonna they're gonna spoil a little bit. So the trailer's gonna be like what little thing I'm gonna have to spoil.
That's basically with Rogue One. They're like. A little bit of Darth Vader. A lot of Darth Vader. Darth Vader's in this movie. Darth Vader. Like,
actually, one of the in the Wired internet searches is like, are there Jedi in Rogue One? And the guy's like, well, Darth Vader was a Jedi. And so this is a spoiler. It's like he's in every fucking trailer except the first one. Like, yeah. Ben Mendelsohn, the guy's playing Grand Moff, whatever the fuck his name is. It was very funny. Probably the funniest part of that trailer, that interview thing. But I'm excited. I saw what you're saying now. I thought you were talking about Mac Wahlberg. There's your Mac Wahlberg. Mac Wahlberg, though. Yes. Okay. We'll get to that soon, guys. Sorry. I think it will definitely have a trailer. I think it would be fucking awesome if it didn't. But I know they're not going to do that because that's. Because they're dumb enough people that are like, I need a trailer. I don't know when to go see a movie. They all voted for Trump, by the way. But, yes. President-elect Trump. Sorry. Sorry, guys. Sorry, George Wasson. For the podcast, George Wasson.
George, if you watch this, give us a thumbs down, please.
Or put a comment. Put a comment that we're... Like, if you don't watch it, just put a comment. You know... That makes no sense. And then we'll get back to you. Speaking of comments that don't make any sense. Aquaman, man, is going to be a family affair.
Oh, okay. I have this on mine, too.
Okay, good. Because Patrick Wilson has been cast as a high-tech pirate villain.
No, Patrick Wilson, if you guys don't remember him, he was not the Night Owl.
The only thing you'll remember is, yes.
Also, he was the voice of the president of Batman versus Superman, so...
Maybe it's connection.
Or dumb. That's dumb. Why would they do that?
It's mad. It's called.
That's dumb.
That's how it works.
That's dirty, guys. Come on.
So,
at least it's just a voice camera.
A high-tech pirate villain and Aquaman's half-brother named Orm Curry, a.k.a. Ocean Master.
So he's going to be like a steampunk dude.
A.k.a. Cool. Man.
Steampunk.
Ocean Master.
He's like a main...
Like, he's a dude. He's a dude that was like, Coma the Ocean Master.
He's like Sting, you know. He's got to be badass if you just say someone gives this really stupid name.
First they of all, call me
like Sting. The Ocean Master. Like Sting, his name is stupid.
Orm.
Worm.
Sting's real name is Gordon, by the way.
Gordon's not a horrible
name. It's a stupid name. It's like, but then he said, somebody call me Sting. And they're like, okay. Like Sting the sword? He's like, no, like a stinger. Oh, like the sword. I like the Hobbit movie. Or the book back then.
And see, the analog Matt is making in this weird segue is that Orm Curry actually told someone to call him the Ocean Master. So Ocean Master is basically, he causes natural disasters, and he wears a cool underweather high-tech bathing suit.
And he's the master of the G to the F and D ocean, obviously.
So he's basically like underwater Iron Man. But a bad guy.
Okay.
He's gonna fight Aquaman.
I want him to look more steampunkish, like a pirate captain or something, I don't know.
Oh, he might, and who knows.
That's what I want.
You want a diving bell?
Yeah, like a diving bell.
I'm gonna get you, Aquaman.
Or he just has his Night Owl costume.
Grub, grub. They'll play that new song in there. I'm down. Let's do it. Let's do it, Aquaman.
You're gonna have sex with Aquaman.
I'm still a little excited for the Aquaman movie, just because it sounds better than Aquaman. So I'm cool. I want to see a trailer first, though. Show me a trailer, and maybe you'll get me on board.
There has been some badass Aquaman stories, but they're smushed in between so many shitty Aquaman stories that it's tough to be like, yay, Aquaman!
You know? I like how you said there are some bad Aquaman stories
smushed between shitty ones. There's some good ones.
They're just
smushed in between so many shitty ones.
The only good one you're thinking of is when he gets his hand ripped off and he gets it hooked up in place, because that's pretty awesome.
This one, probably not, though.
But it's going to be Jason Momoa playing him. So
maybe they'll have that dude. Maybe they'll have the shark dude guy with the big old shark head.
King Shark. He's a flash
king
villain.
King Shark?
For reasons. You know why he's a flash villain, Matt, though? Because he's like, Aquaman can just command me to do things. So I'm going to be a flash villain instead.
Yeah, but he's fast flash, and I'm just a shark.
You think the flash just be like, can you get this guy from back? Get away from Oaken.
Like, why is he having a problem with Shark King though? That's the King Shark.
Because he's really fast in water, so he's like, I'm doing water crimes, and then Flash is like, I have to get him in the water.
Aquaman's like, I'm too busy for the King Shark.
You're but you also think this Flash could probably swim fast too, because he's a Flash.
You know, they really didn't work that part out yet.
Guys, you can drink now. So
that's right. Bright.
Sexy and bright.
So woolly, bright. Oh, precious.
Hey. Bright. He's taking back Mac Wahlberg.
Here.
Hey, it's Mac Wahlberg. So he officially dropped out of the Uncharted movie.
Oh.
Okay. Oh, we were all hoping he was going to be Nathan Drake. We weren't.
But will Robert De Niro still play his uncle? Slash friend?
How dare you?
I'm your uncle slash friend.
Sully.
Sully Wahlberg.
Sullivan. But they call me Sullivan, not Sully.
Hey, because I played myself like
they call me Sully, Sullivan.
My friends call me Sully
you.
You know, that's what I do.
Nate, they only let you call me that. That's one for my Robert De Niro, two for your Robert De Niro, but
mine's
only
one.
Mine's gonna win.
One.
Because he's just going like this. You look like a beetle or something.
Look at all the
lonely
people. Yeah, shake your head.
A beetle?
Yeah. Like one of the Beatles. You know?
What are you talking about?
So shake your head at this.
So Sean Levy is still directing.
For how long?
Well, he did make some money off Stranger Things, so maybe they'll renegotiate his contract and be like, please stay. Supposedly he has several actors in mind for the lead part. He's been soft courting them.
Who'd you pick, Matt?
Who would I pick for Nathan Drake right now? Oh man, that's tough. I'd probably pick Chris Pratt, but he's in everything else, so it's tough.
One of the questions was, is Chris Pratt the new Harrison Ford? And he's like, there's only one Chris Pratt. And he drops the card. I'm like, nice.
I think he'd be a terrific Nathan Drake. There's not too many other people that are like, I'd have
really,
to like, I have to like.
Well, the thing with Nathan Drake too is he has to be, he's not a badass. Like, he's,
yeah.
Like, he's a badass when you play him
and
you shoot pirates in the head.
He's affable.
But he's affable and he gets really lucky, basically, is what happens, you know, or unlucky in some circumstances, you know, where he's like jumping, he's like, I got this, and then he falls off a cliff and he's rolling down this thing.
He's also
indestructible. Yeah. But
he's just like Chris Pratt. Well, you know, I think he really gave that quality in Star-Lord in the Guardians of the Galaxy. So, like, he's like this guy that just gets lucky half the time, basically, to beat the person he's fighting. So, and that's kind of how Nathan Drake is, you know? Like, he gets in a lot of trouble, but he somehow gets out of it and lives to fight another day.
Gets the girl, kind of, sometimes.
He's still with her at the end, right? They didn't break up.
Spoilers.
You should have played it by now. He has several actors in mind. I don't know who, though. I really can't think of who off the top.
Yeah, so Joe Carnahan also is still writing the script for that, by the way, which is good.
And he's done some wilderness stuff, so that's kind of...
Like The Gray. Wolves are killing machines.
Do you think Liam Neeson will be Sully?
I hope Liam Neeson is Sully. And Nathan Drake. I wish all the parts.
It's always 11.
I'm... Nate. What are you doing, Nate?
I'm so pretty, Nate.
Wolves are killing machines, Nate.
Matt, speaking of Joe Carnahan, hold on, I have a Joe Carnahan thing on here, actually.
You had another Joe Carnahan.
I do, sadly. It is on here, hold on. Joe Carnahan, where is he? Joe Carnahan, Cloverfield. Is he?
No.
No, I don't know.
Suicide Squad.
No, right here.
What else do you got?
Spider-Man sequel, Matt. The date has already been set for July 5th, 2019.
Okay.
So there's a bunch of other Sony stuff that is getting bumped because of that. But the biggest one is they're bumping Sony's big budget Bad Boys 4, which is getting moved actually earlier to March 24th, 2018.
So there's nothing wrong with that, right?
Nothing wrong with that. Oh.
So you get Bad Boys. But Bad Boys.
But remember, they said Bad Boys 3.
What happened? Where is that?
Hasn't happened yet. So that's also happening.
I just assumed it went straight to video.
Bad Boys for Life, it's called. And it's going to be released January 18th. Oh, no, this must be 2019. So May 24th, 2019 for Bad Boys 4, but January 18th, 2018 with Joe Carnahan as director.
So Bad Boys for Life, but then there's Bad Boys 4. So that'd be Bad Boys, the Fate of the Bad Boys, maybe.
Yeah, the fate of the Fate of the Furious Bad Boys.
The Fate of the Furious Bad Boys with Vin Diesel.
Maybe they just call them Bad Men by then, because they're going to be super cool.
Bad Boys to Men, maybe?
And is Martin Lawrence alive?
Maybe they'll have the rest of Boys to Men in...
No, like, this is a legitimate question. Do you think Martin Lawrence is still alive?
We should Google that.
Is he alive?
He's still alive. He is. Unless 2016 takes him at the last... You just jinxed him. He's going to die.
He's not going to make it
there. December 31st. He's dead now.
He's so fucking drunk.
Only his career is dead. His career is dead. That's it.
Oh no, I hear them Bad Boys coming.
Can't stop now.
Go to continue my running.
Hopefully Nelly's got another jam on this one. Or maybe we can bring back an even less relevant person like Chingy or somebody like that.
Yeah, Chingy's still out there. He's probably...
Jada Kiss is going to be touring, so maybe they can get him to do it. Okay. He's still alive as well. He's probably living with Martin Lawrence. So the only thing I have left is Sinequel Martin Green will be playing a lieutenant commander on this Star Trek Discovery. She'll actually be a lieutenant commander on the Discovery ship. So she's going to be one of the main characters.
So I said, yes.
Now, you've known her. She was Sasha in Walking Dead, so will she be killed off?
Yes.
Will she be killed off? Huh?
No. Actually, according to reports, she's going to be still doing that full-time.
She's working hard.
So make that money. She's a working actress, yeah.
Make good for her.
That's cool. I think she has good acting chops, and I think she'll be a good part of at least what they're setting up for other actors in that show. Anthony Rapp,
and she's the first
being
a
main character.
She's the first black woman that's also a main character. I mean,
Lieutenant Commander as well.
You sort of count Whoopi Goldberg, but she was like the
but Matt. Will they make her
magical genie?
Will they make her
Klingon? No, she's. I think she's supposed to be a human. They do have. They did.
They haven't said her name.
Say two Klingons, but I think she's supposed to be a human. That's what I heard. They did have two Klingons that were semi-famous actors, but I forgot to put them down. I should have.
What a dick!
I was doubled over and shaking you yesterday.
Doesn't count.
That's all I got, though. Yeah.
So Matt, how about the Suicide Squad, Matt?
You're saving this for last.
No, there's actually one more. Okay. That's horrible. I know, two more.
You got a lot of stuff. Jeez, I got a lot of stuff.
I should probably go back to Spider-Man first. So let's go back to Spider-Man, because there's more Spider-Man 2. So have you seen the trailers for this?
Yeah.
There's a Homecoming. They have two new trailers, an American trailer and an international trailer. The American trailer is cool, because it kind of like portrays it as a more like high school-ish movie. Like as a quirky
Crooky Peter Parker and High School Music.
So this is going to be like Twilight with spiders.
Kind of. There's a little bit of action. They show a little bit of action at the front part, and then there's like, there's a larger Asian-looking dude who I think is the character Gonki. Gonki is a character in the Miles Morales comic book world, and he's actually Miles Morales' best friend in that world. And the only person that knows his secret.
So this guy seems to find out Peter Parker's secret in this thing.
Well, see, it seems like maybe they're setting it up to be like maybe they're infusing Peter Parker in as that Miles Morales.
It's like he's like the white Miles Morales thing.
Kind of. Like they're whitening Miles Morales, possibly. Hopefully not. It's a very high school comedy feel. Like, oh, you should ask her out. Look at her dress. She's so cute.
You heard it from this guy right here. It's Twilight with spiders and the white Morris,
Miles Morales. And there's a little bit of action technically, but the international trailer actually was a really cool too, because it was almost completely different trailer. It was very action oriented, and it showcased more of the mentoring relationship between Tony Stark and Peter Parker, and then Michael Keaton's Adrian Toomes as the Vulture. As a very menacing, the Vulture. Like, he's basically like, I'm going to find and kill all your friends and family, dude.
Yeah, I saw that. I was like,
and he's also wearing, like, an armored Vulture costume.
He's a kid.
That looks almost like an Iron Man-type costume. Like, maybe he's another kind of industrialist or something.
Maybe he just stole some more Stark Tech. Stark Tech.
Like, Stark's like, I made this cool bird suit. I just left it out.
It's like, I thought I blew it up.
Oh, yeah, I didn't blow it. Someone stole it.
Just go get him,
Spider. I should stop drinking. I'm always drinking.
I did like the little interaction he had in the car, and he reached over. He's like, I'm not giving you a hug. I'm just going to open the door. Get out.
He like puts his arm like. He's like, I'm not giving you a hug. I'm just opening the door for you.
That's pretty funny.
Marco Polo and Matt canceled after season 2.
Speaking of transitions, Marco Polo.
Canceled.
I didn't even watch second season.
We tried to watch Marco Polo, but
I watched the first season. I really liked
the first season, but we didn't really get into the second season.
I never really got
it. But it got canceled, which is uncharacteristic for Netflix.
Are you sure it was uncharacteristic?
For Netflix, it was uncharacteristic.
Thank you.
But it's a mutual agreement between Netflix and the Weinstein Company to cancel it. But other things like Hemlock Grove and Bloodlines were given a final season. So, yeah. Which is why it's strange for Netflix.
And Hemlock Grove was utter crap.
Bloodlines was it? Bloodlines is okay, but it wasn't great.
I heard it was okay, but not great.
Linda Cardellini was good in it. Kyle Chandler was great. Ben Mendelsohn was great. There's a lot of good actors. It got in the weeds real quick, in that one. But I was thinking, the reason I put this down, because I was thinking, is Netflix really, because Netflix, you know, they're already like in huge debt.
Bloated.
Yeah. Do you think they're in trouble right now? Like, do you think like our premiums are going to go up to like $50 for a month or something? Like,
I wouldn't put anything past it, but I know that they need to start, if a show's not doing good, cancel it. You have enough shows.
I agree. Netflix, I know
you have like 14 Marvel shows now. You have Stranger Things doing well for you.
Get rid of them.
You keep giving Adam Sandler goddamn money. And Kevin James, Kevin James make a movie.
I think that was part of the Adam Sandler.
It better have been, because that's bullshit.
But Kevin
James gets famous, and this guy has to stay and work every day.
And Kevin James looks just like a lunchbox, too.
I'm a better lunchbox than he is.
I'm saying, look at this beard, look at this.
Look, I could...
It's very camera ready. You think you'd be an international assassin?
Yes. No, he's not an international. He's a guy who writes about international, but then they think he's one. It's a mistaken identity comedy.
That's why I think it's...
And he has, like, his wife's probably, like, Tia Leone. Yeah. No, it's actually probably somebody younger and hotter.
Younger and more ethnic as well.
Yeah.
Like, Zoe Saldana's, my hot wife. I came home. Let's have a sex scene now, but it's going to be a funny sex scene.
Yeah, like, I'm going to fart during it.
I'm going to rub my fat, naked body on top of yours. Like, that's how I get off.
No!
We're just saying, stop it. Just stop, Kevin James. We're tired. We're very tired. As fat as Team Fat, we're very tired. You look really good. I like that look right now.
This is the face every time I see a Kevin James making another movie...
But yeah, for like every like good Marvel movie or good like the Stranger Things thing, not Marvel show, there's like a lot of other stuff that's being put out there by Netflix, which is some of it's fun.
Some of
like,
it's, but they don't really
promote it.
They don't promote it. There's that one with Gillian Jacobs.
Jacob's.
Yeah. I'm into that too. And the dude looks like a bird.
The dude that looks like a bird.
He looks like young Woody Allen. Yeah. He's the guy who wrote it. And then he's like, I'm also the lead.
And you're like, and make this hot chick my girlfriend. Yeah. There's also this one called Spectral that's out right now that's in 3%. That's another Netflix original. It's like they don't really promote them. They just kind of throw them up there. And it's like, if you want to watch them, you watch them.
And some of them get like a... I think that's kind of their advertising scheme almost. That's how Stranger Things really came about. Because Stranger Things was not advertised, really. It was just like, hey, there's a show out there. And this show's kind of freaky. Yeah. Let's watch it. And that's how it became a success. And Marvel was just like, it's Marvel. And then like, ah, everybody's watching it. So, you know.
It's Marvel. Like, and some of those are... The Marvel ones have always been either good to great. So it's like... Yeah. Although I feel like they're like... Although I really liked Luke Cage, I feel like Luke Cage was definitely below... below Christmas. Daredevil and below
Jessica Jones
too.
So they can make serious bank on a soundtrack.
But the soundtrack for Luke Cage was legit. I'm the chief.
That's right.
What was that? what was that?
It was Ray, of course.
Wow.
He told me out of combat. What do you have two things left?
Let's see. So, Matt, if you were thinking about, you really wanted a third movie of the Cloverfield universe.
I was hoping for
you're
one.
In luck. You're in luck. You may be in luck because J.J. Abrams produced a movie called The God Particle, which was originally said was to be about crews of two spacecraft. We see that see Earth disappear after an accident with a Large Hadron Collider. Was slotted for February 24th release, but was removed and then was replaced in the fall with a 2017 Cloverfield movie. So since J.J. Abrams is probably not producing two of these movies, they're thinking the God Particle may be the third in this trilogy. That also makes no sense.
Yeah, the trilogy that has nothing to do with anything else, really.
They're just in the same universe.
And why are they in the same universe? maybe if they explained they were doing this large particle
also, why
collider
this,
thing.
Why this dude's in space when this
to try and stop the Cloverfield monster?
Vision.
Yeah, like maybe they were doing it to try
maybe
to stop
John
the monster.
Maybe John Goodman was the Cloverfield monster.
Maybe John Goodman's in space, hopefully.
Hey, I'm here too.
Him in a big old fat space suit.
And Roseanne's there too.
And also,
hey, I'm also here.
I kidnapped this girl in the second one or something. I don't know what was going on with that one.
It's messed up.
Now we're in space together. I don't know why.
So is this more cloak and dagger, or is it just like
I
want to
know? I
want to
like pick his brain, J.J. Abrams' brain for now. I'm like, what's going on with this thing? Why are you doing?
But also, like, I want to find out like how much
your avatar
ayahuasca he had. Like,
is this your avatar? Like, you have to finish this bullcrap, no matter how much it costs you.
But the thing is though, is he's actually finishing it either way.
Which is better than now, James Cameron.
James Cameron's like, yeah, I'm gonna have 17 Avatar movies. The first one is gonna be in 2200. And like, no, that's...
They're going to cryogenically freeze me. They're going to put my head on top of robot bodies so I can finish the movies.
You're going to die soon. You're like in your 60s already. What the fuck is going on?
And also, everyone forgot what Avatar's about. Stop making the movies.
Or just didn't care.
It was a likable movie. If they would have made a sequel 2 years later, it would have been a franchise.
But I mean,
nobody cared
about
this movie.
It did have a great porn spinoff, though.
It basically was its own porn spinoff with the little...
Are you fucking your horse too, Matt? Are you fucking
yes!
horse?
You are 100%
fucking
your horse if you're
that dragon bird thing. Are you fucking that thing?
Sam Worthington fucked his horse.
Oh, yeah.
Gotta fuck my horse. That's how you do it.
I guess we're doing this.
Oh, I'm mystically
much
this
big fake body we made.
They put me in the big fake body. And that's okay. Then I just become the fake body.
Okay. By the way, like, spiritually for the Avatar dudes, like, the Na'vi, like... That's gonna be fucked up for them. Like, this is a clone weird body with a husk that we put a human.
Well, maybe they're saying that
into.
All souls are one.
Fucked up.
Bullshit, I guess.
Fucked up.
But also, is this body, like, completely accurate? I don't know.
No, supposedly it's I don't remember from the movie, it's a hybrid between human and.
I don't care. This is stupid.
And Na'vi. Which means, like, it's like a mule.
So he's gonna. He's gonna taint their race.
Yeah, he's gonna fuck it up.
Yeah, like, they're just gonna.
The
oh, man.
Thank you, James Cameron, for that thought.
I'm sure
should
I explain it when I talk more about unobtainium.
Oh, God. Hey, it makes things float. That's cool, right? Last thing I have, man. Finally.
Because Sweet Mercy.
We're talking about this earlier, but I want to save it for last. Suicide Squad director David Ayer is helping a Gotham City Sirens movie, man.
I like how you're getting more 70s, like, growling rock guy.
Yeah. I heard Suicide Squad director. Like, yesterday I had the action movie voice, but I can't do it today because it actually hurts a little bit. But, Gotham Sirens are a female hero/villains group that team up to fight crime in Gotham.
I have something for this. Keep going. How do you? Okay. So I can't believe you didn't see this.
I didn't. Because, like I said, I didn't look today. The fight crime. The main villainesses are that have been through the Gotham City Sirens project, mm-hmm. through the comic. Mm-hmm. Catwoman, Harley Quinn, Poison Ivy.
Okay.
I know this one already. Harley Quinn has already signed on. Margot Robbie.
Yeah, you know, there's a female actress that's pursuing the Poison Ivy route.
Well, I think that it would probably be like
Academy Award winning,
maybe. Maybe like I don't know. I was thinking like maybe who isn't the great one? Gal Gadot? No, she's already doing something.
Toe Thumbs herself, Mike.
What?
Good old Toe Thumbs.
Megan Fox. I'm out. No way.
100% out.
Fucking no way.
If she gets this movie, I'm 100%
out. No fucking way. Plus the fact that Poison Ivy is like one of the smarter characters of the group. Like, she's a scientist.
I'm very smart.
I'm a scientist.
I am left to God.
I'm a scientist.
Look,
I'm
I have plant thumbs, not toe thumbs.
I'm a scientist.
So who would be Catwoman then? If
what's a good one? Catwoman. You need someone like, you probably wouldn't want someone too young, maybe in the 30s.
I'd say like former porn star Jen Jameson. If you're gonna go with Megan Fox, if you're going with acting quality,
I'm just going for something serious, Matt.
Acting quality.
I've seen you like Marion Cotillard or something like that.
Hi, I'm Catwoman.
Yeah, that's cool.
That's how I talk.
I'm cool with that.
I'm from Gotham City.
Not Mila Kunis. Come on, she's like tiny.
So?
She might as well be Mila Kunis at that point.
We've seen her dance.
Look at the end of the episode,
meow.
Guys.
Meow.
We've seen her dance. Just like a Catwoman.
She still would be better than Megan Fox.
Awesome.
Megan Fox will be like picking Jim Carrey as the Riddler. You might as well just get some bat nipples and keep
going. Okay, Jim Carrey was a great Riddler. I don't want to hear that.
Was he better than Mr. Freeze?
Mr. Freeze.
Hey, chill out! Did you see him here? Yeah, he was on Jimmy Fallon. He's like, you do like the best impression of me.
Jimmy Fallon's doing an impression of me. He's like, you do like the best impression of my voice. It was pretty awesome. That was a good interview.
Mr. Freeze.
He was trying to give Arnold Schwarzenegger his what his catchphrase should be for the show. He's like, you would not be back. and he's just going like this to you.
Just like what his face does. He has like his smile. It's his real smile, but it looks like it's like a fake smile. It's like.
I forgot what he said at the end, but he made him laugh, and it was good. I recommend that as well, guys. Matt will post it in the comments.
Over my eyes, like Jordy.
Thank you for watching, guys.
Thanks for coming.
We love
Stay
you
classy.
So much.
Finn. Bang. Foo.
You got them all. Good night.